So we are playing some GTA Online. Sorry about the l delay. If it loads finally. Turn it down a little bit so you can hear me. I thought we could do a 30 player shop because that's unique to the new gen version of GTA Online. It should be. Where is it? Game lists. And Rockstar lists. And there are two different lists called 30 ways to die and 30 to life. I already tried the second one. Let's try this one. The big problem is the matchmaking in GTA Online, because it's very difficult to get all the players together here. Let's see if we get some people together here. Just a matter of hours till we get 30 players together. Yeah, that's what usually happens. One or two players join and then they leave because they're pissed. And then you never get together 30 players. So I guess we're gonna abort this. Well, Maybe we just do some open world stuff. Or last mission. You can set here the first person perspective in the job as standard, so you can switch to third person, or you can only set third person. Hey, you're there, man, right? So join my GTA 5 game. Do you have a microphone? So David just joined us. You might know him from his review work on NixtGamerD. Oh, and everyone in the game hears me too, right? Okay, we have one spot left in the job. Come on, David, join. You have 15 seconds left to join. But you're in single player, right? Well, the job is starting.
Oh no!
Oh, this is the same mission that I streamed already before. Which is weird because this time we're all on one team. So this is the same mission that I posted on YouTube, the one versus two where I did win with some luck. I think only the transporters are moving now. So I'm gonna go for the second transporter here. Let's just chop down there. Oops. Huh. Okay. That was quick. So the weapon handling is quite different from the PS3 world. Oh, I'm almost at a can. Fuck. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, that's it for this job. I think for the actual game, you can also set the camera filters that you already had in every GTA 5 version in the spectator mode, but you can actually set them while you play. It's kind of cool. Oh, and there are also different effects now than before. So this should be done quite soon. Oh, this effect is... looks good. Yeah, clearly he's the guy with rank 278. What? He's gonna get the second one too? Nah. Right? He's going back to the second one. No, I think we don't want to watch that. You can actually use the touchpad to swipe and change between the weapons and the radio stations. And you can also quick draw the weapon. That would be kind of cool in a next or a new gen Red Dead Redemption when you have the duels and you could draw your gun with a swipe on your touchpad. And the load times didn't improve in the new gen. That's what's cool about Destiny, that you can actually access the menu and all your gear while the game is loading, but you can't do anything here. Can't even change the tooltips here. We might later to stream a few other new games that we got in. And that would be Final Horizon and Never Alone. Really want to play Never Alone because it's kind of an interesting setting, but we're gonna talk about it when we do the actual game. Okay. Shows the muscles. Can we start? But I have no idea how that works. And I'm usually terrible in these mini games. Left or right stick, horizontal. What does horizontal mean? Like this? Oh, that was easy. Only that I lost a little bit of a little bit of my stick there. My analog stick. Well, that's okay. Stuart Marsh. Maybe this time I won't hurt my controller as much. Yeah, but this will be the last one. My stick is already falling apart a little bit on top. Maybe I did a little bit too hard there. The DualShock 3 analog sticks. Could do a little more, before they lose most of their grip. Yeah, I'm actually gonna redeem Neveralone right now where the slots. And then we can show it off later. Well, there are actually Black Friday deals in the European PlayStation Store. I have Shadow of Mordor for 35, and The Walking Dead for PS Plus members is €10 each season on PS4. That's not bad. And Alien Isolation is 25. Oh, that's just the season pass. The actual game is 36, 37. But that's pretty cheap too for an awesome game. So the original title for Neveralone is Kizima Ingichuna. But more of that later when I downloaded it. So we're back in GTA Online. Oh, and there's another player. And he wanted to drive over me, but I dodged that. Bitch. Fuck police. Oh, I'm so bad at aiming. Oh, there's another player behind me. Where's the car? The car disappeared. What the fuck you want? Maybe I should get some vehicle. do a little first person chase. Oh, that's cool. You just press the action cam button, then you see the view of the helicopter that's chasing you. And you can actually... Oh, that's the wrong button apparently. I don't know. No, it's L1. With L1, if you keep L1 pressed, then you draw your gun. And then with the right stick you can freely aim. And then with R1 you can shoot, so that actually works okay, but you need some practice. What was this plan? And you can actually, I think, look back. If you press, if you keep pressing R3, so the right stick, and then draw your gun with L1 and then press R1 to shoot, you can actually shoot back. But that's too many buttons for me to press at the same time. Okay, let's try to get away from that. Okay, the helicopter is turning. Maybe let's just go this way. Oh no. Stupid tree. What is going on? Yeah, it explodes, right? Yeah, the environment looks actually pretty nice in GTA 5 for new gen, but I haven't encountered any of the animals, the wildlife, that is supposed to be in this version. Maybe I'm just too blind to see it, but I haven't seen a single deer, for example. I think there are more birds, but birds are so small you barely see them from the game. But yeah, also the flowers and everything, and the grass and the wind is more voluminous. So everything is just a little bit expanded. Where am I actually going here? Maybe I should get a helicopter extraction. Oh, where is that now? Should be Meriwether.
Meriwether, for all your private security needs, how can I help? Thank you. A helicopter is on its way.
I'm carrying $30,000 with me. Maybe I should go to a bank and secure that money before somebody robs me. Is that my chopper or no? Is that another player? No. Is he coming? If only the Cabela games would look like this. Did I miss something? Maybe I wasn't on a spot where the helicopter can actually land. Maybe I should have paid more attention when the call was made. Try it again, but they deducted then $10,000 from me, so it should come.
Hello, you're through to Meriwether Security Consulting. What can I do for you?
And it's 1,000, not 10,000. Well, okay.
An air unit's on its way.
Another 1,000 gone. That'll come. Okay, now it comes. Oh yeah, it was quick. Usually you can now fly with them, but I'm just gonna take the helicopter, of course. Would be cool if you actually could zoom in and see all the displays. Closer. You can see acceleration, the velocity, you can see in which direction. Oh, that looks pretty good. Which direction you move. We're just gonna fly west into the sunset of Los Santos. So yeah, flying is a lot more smoother than on PS3, but it might be because of the new controller. And the sun is gone. Let's look for some players. Oh. So yeah, you see the frame rate drops a lot if you move fast. Usually it's quite alright. You can actually look down there, that's cool. That wasn't so cool. But you can't actually draw your weapon here. Which is understandable. Oh yeah, that was good. But we're still okay. Video games. And here we could do a small gang shooting. Why not? If I manage to get down without incidents, I think it won't explode. No, it's alright. So there's usually one gang member you have to take out and then the shooting starts. But now you can see on the radar it all disappeared. I guess this gang shooting is gone. Is there anything good on? Maybe the radio is a little bit quiet. Not the best at landing.
Listen, give me a shout if you ever want to do a bounty. It's an easy way to make some money. Oh.
Oh, Simeon wants this car, so why not deliver it to him? Oh, well, Simeon again. Wasn't he here? No. Oh, he usually was there. Where's the big ass? I guess we have to go first to clean it up and then we can go to Simeon. Oh, that's too much work. A nice car. Stupid people. There's another mission. Let's take this mission, whatever it is. Oh, I think I haven't played this. Sixteen players. When do you ever get together 16 players in this game? That's what I mean with matchmaking. You can, I think in 1 out of 10 cases you have luck and you instantly get some players together. But in 9 of 10 cases you just wait in the lobby. That's the only thing else GTA Online besides the loading times. That's really nerve-wracking at times. So I'll be back in a bit and then we'll see if this works. As the matchmaking is clearly not working, and free roam only makes sense when you're in a group of players, which I'm not right now. So then we would stream later on, and then we would stream Never Alone and probably Final Horizon on PS4. And until then, we take a little break. Enjoy your Black Friday, and thanks for watching.